Welcome to Optical Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be solving examples based on photo detector. And these examples, that is based on my previous session, where I have explained quantum efficiency and responsivity. So based on that formulas, now we will solve examples here in this session. So let us have first problem. Now see, in first question, a photodiode has quantum efficiency of 65% that is given. So here, let me mention all those data which is given to us. Efficiency is 65% means 0.65. When photons of energy 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule are incident on it. So energy is given. 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. At what wavelength is the photodiode is operating? So we are delivered to calculate wavelength. And in second question, calculate the incident optical fiber, optical power required to obtain photo current of 2.5 microampere. So here photo current is given, that is 2.5 microampere when photodiode is operating as above. So here these are the data which is given to us, and first we are dealing with to identify at what wavelength photodiode is operating. So wavelength that we can calculate based on energy. See, the basic relation of energy and wavelength is E is equals to hc divided by lambda. So from that we can calculate lambda, that is hc by E. Now see, h is Planck constant, that is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 into c is velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by energy that is given to us, 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 19. So if we calculate this, we'll be having lambda. So 6.625 into 3 divided by 1.5. So this is 13.25, and into power will be minus 34 plus 8 minus minus plus 19. So into 10 power 10 to the power minus 7. So I can say this is 1.325 micrometer. So this is what wavelength at which this photodiode is operating. Now next question is to calculate optical power. Now see, optical power that we can calculate based on responsivity. So first we need to calculate responsivity here. So responsivity R, that I have already told you, it is efficiency into charge into lambda divided by hc. It is eta q lambda divided by hc. Now we need to place all the data which we have. Eta is 0.65, q is charge of electron, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, lambda that we have calculated 1.325 micro means 10 to the power minus 6, h is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34, and c is velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8. So let us calculate this first. See, this is 0.65 into 1.6 into 1.325 divided by 6.625 divided by 3. So 0.06933, and into, now I'll calculate power, that is minus 19 minus 6 divided by means minus minus plus 34 divided by 8 means minus 8, so that is 1. So 10 to the power 1, so we can say this is 0.6933 ampere per watt. So responsivity that we have calculated and that is 0.6933 ampere per watt, and wavelength that is 1.325 micrometer. Now our question is calculate incident optical power. And see, I have already explained you this relation of responsivity with optical power, that is photocurrent divided by optical power. And here photocurrent is given 2.5 microampere, so 2.5 micro means 10 to the power minus 6 divided by responsivity, that is 0.6933. So if we calculate this, we'll be having, sorry, here optical power that we are delivered to calculate. So we can say from this formula, optical power, that is photocurrent divided by responsivity. So photocurrent that is given 2.5 microampere, and responsivity that is 0.6933. So if we calculate this, 2.5 divided by 0.6933, then that will be 3.6, and I can say it is micro watt. So this is how we can calculate optical power on that photo diode based on responsivity, and responsivity that we can calculate based on wavelength, and wavelength that we can calculate based on energy. Let us have one more problem so it will be more clear. Now see, in second problem, a PN diode has quantum efficiency of 50%. So quantum efficiency that is given 50% means 0.5 at a wavelength of 0.9 micrometer. So lambda that is 0.9 micrometer. Calculate responsivity, and second is the received optical power if photocurrent is 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. So here photocurrent is given, that is 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. So responsivity that we can calculate as per basic formula, eta q lambda divided by hc, and all the data that we have, eta is 0.5 efficiency, charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, lambda is 0.9 micrometer, so for micro 10 to the power minus 6 divided by h, Planck constant 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34, and c that is velocity of light 3 into 10 to the power 8. Now let us calculate this. 0.5 into 1.6 into 0.9 divided by 6.625 divided by 3. So that is 0.03622. So this is 0.03622. And if I calculate power, so power is minus 19, minus 6, minus minus plus 34, minus 8, so that is 1. So this is 10 to the power 1, so we can say this is 0.3622, and the unit of responsivity is ampere per watt. So now we have responsivity, and based on responsivity we have a relation of optical power. So that is responsivity is equals to photocurrent divided by optical power. So we can say optical power, that is photocurrent divided by responsivity, and photocurrent that is 10 to the power minus 6, responsivity that we have calculated, it is 0.3622. So now we have optical power that will be 1 divided by 0.3622. So that is 2.76 into 10 to the power minus 6 means microwatt. So that is how we can calculate responsivity, optical power, energy of signal. So all those data that we can calculate as per these basic formulas. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos which will solve all those queries which is required to be solved on my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.